Greetings, my little zonelings. I'm Zonetan, and welcome back to another episode of Education, the show where you're put on the Japanese Nonviolent Sex Offender Registry just by watching it.
Today we're going to be covering a term that, if you spent any kind of time on certain parts of the internet, you're probably already familiar with. Ahegao.
And for some, that's the only way they would ever know what it looks like. Yes, I'm looking at you, Dave.
Die in a tire fire, Zonetan. The term ahegao, literally translated, means panting face, and it, well, is pretty self-explanatory. The term comes from a Japanese onomatopoeia, ahe ahe, which is basically the way the Japanese phoneticize panting, the same way they phoneticize a cat's meow as nya. Side note, the fact that it's an onomatopoeia is why ahegao is spelled with katakana instead of hiragana or kanji, since it's used to denote sounds and borrowed words.
Japanese naughty words are filled with other onomatopoeias. Onomatopoeia?
Just roll with it.
There's a lot of words in Japanese that are supposed to sound like what they are or do, especially when it comes to sex. Dave, remind us to circle back to Gokun one day.
It's on the list. One important thing to remember, Zonelings, is that while we all know that ahegao are the faces made in hentai and ironically detached memes, it's not exactly correct to call it the O face. The more direct term for that would be ikigao, which is literally translated as coming face.
Like Netorade before, using the term ikigao in a sentence is a bit tricky because of its specificity. But if you wanted to, you could say, I saw her O face by saying, Kanojo no ikigao wo mita.
Conversely, if you wanted to let your partner know that you want to see their O-face, you could be a bit assertive and just give the old DASHITE! Or perhaps the moment of truth is just seconds away, and you being the polite partner you are, you could say... IKISO!
Which brings us to our last word. YAMERO.
That doesn't have anything to do with...
YAMERO!